Hello, hello, it's me, the feisty Filipina. Did you miss me? Well, I'm back, so I hope you're ready. My gosh, I think the last podcast was back in June, or was it July? See, I can't even remember anymore. Well, I'm back, and I hope you're excited to listen to all my babblings on showbiz news as much as I'm itching to babble about showbiz news. There's a lot of them, so let's get to it.
You can talk all you want, but my skin is really thick. I'm the leader of the crowd, and my game is really slick. I'm unstoppable, 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 unstoppable. You can talk.
First up on our showbiz news to talk about is the supposed breakup of Bea Alonzo and Gerald Anderson. Apparently, the two have decided to break up while they were still in London doing a concert with Pio Pasquale, Sam Melby, John Lloyd Cruz, and Paul Kwang. If I missed anybody, I apologize, but yeah, guess the two decided to break up. Interestingly enough, I don't recall any of them admitting to anything. As a matter of fact, they did everything they could to deny it, or at least avoid answering any questions related to whatever relationship they have or might have had. So how are they all of a sudden going to break up, right? Well, I do have a couple of theories if you want to listen to them. Well, you don't have a choice because you're listening to my podcast, so here they go. First one is that I think ABS-CBN is doing damage control. I think they finally realized that when a Kim Bearald fan said they were pissed off, they meant it, damn it. So now, ABS-CBN wants to put this idea out there that even though Gerald and Bea were in London together, albeit with other people, they weren't actually being romantic or doing any lovey-dovey moments because they broke up, so Gerald is a free man. Yeah, free man to be with Kim or their love team at least, right? So, ABS-CBN wants those fans to go to see the movie, you know? Till My Heart Aches End or something like that? So, yeah, ticket sales, right? And my second theory is that maybe they really broke up. Maybe someone talked to them and said, okay, kids, it's time to pick your careers or your relationship. Do I believe they broke up? No. I think they're in the level of getting to know each other. Maybe eventually they'll get to the boyfriend-girlfriend status. But I guess right now we have to believe that they broke up. Showbiz. I don't know if you've noticed, but it's been quiet from the Robin Padilla and Mariel Rodriguez side. Oh yeah, now you've noticed, huh? Now that I've mentioned it. Yeah, after being inundated with everything that's Robin and Mariel for like 3 months, everything is quiet. It's smooth sailing. No mention of Robin and Mariel anywhere. Well, until I open my big mouth right here in my podcast, right? Wonder where they are. Oh, I know, yeah. Yeah, I'll answer my own question, please. I think they're in India shooting a movie. Yeah, oh yeah, I saw pictures of them under a thread over at Pinoy Exchange Forum. Yep. The pictures look like Robin Padilla's version of Bend It Like Beckham. Yeah, there you go. So let's just enjoy the quietness until the storm comes back.
You can talk all you want, but my skin is really thick. I'm the leader of the crowd, and my game is really slick. I'm unstoppable, 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 unstoppable. Said you pity for tomorrow, and I'll smash it like a ball. In the club, on the news, I'll be rocking like a rock. I'm unstoppable, 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 unstoppable.
So I saw a couple of headlines from various sites the other day, pertaining to a judge giving Kris Aquino and James Yap gag orders. That means they're not allowed to talk to the press about their divorce or annulment or settlement or custody hearings or whatever. Yeah, there's a lot of ors in that sentence. Anywho, you would think that would help, right? Not really. I think James Yap took the gag order seriously, because he had an interview with Ricky Lo the other day, and he said he'd rather not talk about Kris. Well, too bad for him, because Kris was ready to talk about him on Twitter, no less. Yep, she started posting a song for him. I think it's called Cool from Gwen Stefani. She even posted lyrics from the song. And apparently, James Yap dedicated Pa'alamna. Kris didn't know the lyrics, so she googled and then started posting the lyrics on Twitter. Now, okay, one could argue that Twitter is not press. However, Kris Aquino knows that there's a lot of press people watching Twitter and watching her Twitter account. So they are just waiting for her tweets. You know what I mean? Lo and behold, everything that she posted on her Twitter on that day were posted on a tabloid magazine online. Yep. You know, believe it or not, I actually like Kris Aquino. But sometimes, she just really need to be quiet, you know? Take that gag order seriously. Just be quiet for now. Just wait until everything is settled. And then you can talk and talk and talk and talk. Just my advice, of course. She doesn't need to take it.
Now shake your body like you got the jungle fever rushing through your veins. We getting crazy in the club, it's banging through your brain. When I say jump, you jump.
This is more like a commentary on a few shows I've been watching from Pinoy TV lately. It's gonna get a little childish, but humor me, okay? On Love Star, I think Sarah Lahbati is actually good. I think she's showing great potential. She's kind of mediocre on Party Filipinas. I mean, she could dance and she's got rhythm, but there's always something missing from her performances. I mean, I want her to shake more. She's not like Yassi, Winwin, or Diva. Now, those girls would kill you with their moves, but Sarah, she's a little weak. But she's good on a Little Star. On Beauty Queen, when Maggie and Iza were fighting, Maggie went for Iza's hair. And then on the preview, Katrina went for Iza's hair. And then going back to Little Star, every time the stepmother's pissed off, she's always going for either Sarah or Jen's hair. And then on Griselda, if I remember the fight scene, I think Gliza went for Yasmin's hair. She actually dragged Yasmin by the hair, right? It's always the hair. Why can't you guys punch or kick? I mean, there's always like slapping scene, but it's always the hair first or the second. I'm surprised their wigs are not falling off. Well, there you go. I told you I could be childish. Someone requested that I talk about the fact that the Magalana siblings are now part of a GMA Artist Center. It's okay, I guess. I mean, maybe we'll see a show with all of them in it. Hey, it could be worse. It could be the Gutierrez's. Oh wait, that happens already. I mean, I like Elmo. He's good. He's good in Party Pilipinas. And I saw potential from him on Pili and Caribbean. But then he started being on every show. You know what I mean? Like, I mean, there's not even a gap. It's like every 2 days or so. So I kind of lost my clamor for him. I kind of want him to, like, take a rest for, like, 6 months. I mean, the Julie Elmo fans are going to kill me, but I'm talking about, like, teleseries or sitcoms, you know? Just be on Party Pilipinas for a bit. And then wait for a year before you be on another show. Maxine, she's okay. She could act. She's a good crier. Sab, well, the jury's still out there. I'm still watching her. And that other one, that little kid, I can't remember his name. Sorry, Pia, I don't remember your kid's name. But Arkin, I think? Yeah, I mean, he's good. And I hope JMA will take care of him. But I think he's too young to be on every show right now. So, well, maybe he and Jillian would do a show together, right? It'd be cool. So yeah, I mean, I guess it's okay. It could be worse, like I said. This concludes our podcast for today. Thank you very much for listening here at FilipinasInShowbiz.com. If you guys have any requests, please don't hesitate to email us at FilipinasInShowbiz@gmail.com. This podcast is brought to you by Super Indai and the Magic Bibi. Don't forget to watch on December. Be there or be squared. Thanks.